Hello students, myself Siddheshwar B. Tuljapure, Associate Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today we are going to deal with the topic from the section Fluid Dynamics, and the topic is application of Bernoulli's theorem, that is Orificemeter. The learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to explain construction and working of orificemeter. Orificemeter, we are knowing that it is used for the measurement of the discharge, and it is out of the three applications, that is venturimeter is also used for the measurement of discharge, and one more is there, that is spit out tube, used for the measurement of velocity of flow. Now let us see the construction of the orificemeter. So as compared to the construction of the venturimeter, we are having the simplicity in case of the orificemeter. So in case of the orificemeter, we have to cut the pipe at one of the sections, then we are going to introduce this orifice plate. So this yellow colored part, it is shown as orifice plate here. So it is having to some extent the sharp edge, and then we are going to have the measurement of the difference in the pressure with the help of the manometer. Then we are having the flow from the left hand side to the right hand side. Now we can observe that we are having the flow as to some extent it is with the diameter of that fluid flow it is getting reduced. So initially at this particular section the fluid it is touching to the boundaries continuously, and here in case of the orifice plate, here the sharp edge is there. So because of the sharp edge of the orifice, we are going to have the reduction in the energy of the fluid. So due to the loss of that energy due to the sharp edge of the orifice, the fluid flow it is getting contracted, and we are having at this particular section the reduced diameter of the fluid flow it is, and it is the smallest cross section area, and which have been named as vena contracta, and the diameter of this one it is called as diameter of vena contracta or vena contracta diameter. So this is one section where we are going to attach one of the tappings of the manometer, and one more section is there, that is before the orifice plate, where the full fluid flow is there, and then these two tappings we are going to have, and we are going to measure the pressure drop in between these two with the help of the differential manometer. Now fluid flow it is from the left hand side to the right hand side, and we are going to consider the section 1 and the section 2 at the vena contracta portion, and we are having the orifice plate in between these two. Now let us start with the derivation. So in case of the discharge through the orifice plate, we are going to have this derivation. So applying Bernoulli's theorem at section 1 and section 2. Section 1 it is of pipe only, and section 2 belongs to the vena contracta. In case of this one, say the Bernoulli's theorem, it is P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 is equal to, it is P2 by rho G plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2. So here Z1 is equal to Z2. Then rearranging the terms, it is P1 by rho G minus P2 by rho G is equal to V2 square by 2G minus V1 square by 2G. So let us say that the difference in the pressure head is equal to, it is H. So small h we can indicate, and this one is equal to V2 square minus V1 square divided by, it is 2G. So we can rearrange the terms, it is V2 square minus V1 square is equal to, we can write it as 2gh. Now, in this case, from continuity equation, from continuity equation, A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Now, in case of this one, we are going to introduce one parameter called as coefficient of contraction. It is coefficient of contraction is equal to CC. So we have observed in case of the construction that the diameter of the flow it is getting reduced. So there the diameter of the orifice is there one, and next to that one the diameter of the flow at the vena contracta portion, that is the vena contracta diameter. So the ratios of these areas at the two places can be taken, and here we are going to have the diameter, considering the diameter of the vena contracta portion, the area can be calculated, it is A2, and the area of the orifice we can have, which is equal to AO, we are writing. So in this case, it is A2 can be written as CC into it is AO. So now replacing this one, so in case of the equation, it is A1 V1 is equal to, it is CC into it is AO into it is V2. Then V1 is equal to, we can write, it is CC, that is coefficient of contraction, area of orifice, then it is V2 divided by it is A1. Then the value of V1 we have got in terms of the V2. So let us put this value in this equation where we are having V2 and V1, and now both can be put in terms of the V2 only. So now it is V2 square minus, see this one, it is V1 square. So here it will be CC square AO square, then it is V2 square divided by, it will be A1 square, will be equal to 2GH. Now can have the V2 square common, so it is V2 square into bracket, it is 1 minus CC square AO square divided by, it is A1 square, and this one is equal to, say it is 2GH. So let us simplify the bracket, it is V2 square into bracket, it will be A1 square minus CC square AO square, so then divided by, it is A1 square is equal to, it is 2GH. Then it is V2 square is equal to, we can write, so this one A1 square will be taken to the right hand side, A1 square into it is 2GH divided by, it is A1 square minus CC square and multiplied by AO square. Then it is V2, we can write, say the square root of both the sides we have taken, so this one will be A1, then it is under root 2GH, then it is A1 square minus CC square and AO square, the whole thing will be under root only. So from equation, it is discharge Q is equal to, say we are having this one as A2 V2, then this Q is equal to, it is A2 into it is A1, so value of V2 we are going to put, it is under root 2GH divided by, it is under root, it is A1 square minus CC square and AO square. Now this one can be written as Q is equal to, we will take this here, it is A1 A2, it is under root 2GH divided by, so it is under root A1 square minus CC square and it is AO square. So now this can be written in some another form. So what we can have is, we can have replacement of some of the parts, and then instead of going for it is A2, we can go for AO, which is the area of the orifice, and then next to that one we are going to have, it is say A1 square, then again CC square is there, then AO square is there, instead of AO square also we can go for say A2 square it is. So in case of this one AO square, we will keep it as it is, but cc square we are going to convert it. So now the same can be written as, say now here in case of this one, a2 divided by under root, it is a1 square minus cc square into it is ao square, can be written as, you say it is cd into it is under root a1 square minus ao square. See now in this case we are going to have the, in the earlier equation it is a1 and then it is a2. A2 we cannot measure, so because of which we are going to have the replacement. Replacement will be in terms of the area of the orifice. So it is area of the orifice we will write. So the terms which we are changing, you can observe it is a2 is replaced by ao, a1 square is kept as it is, and then this one we are going to change. So this one is going to simplify the thing. So q is equal to, it will be cd into, so it is a0 a1, it is under root 2gh divided by, it is under root a1 square minus it is ao square. So this is the equation which we are going to make use, and this cd, it is nothing but it is coefficient of discharge. These are the references.